retracing the steps of Dr. King to celebrate his 50th anniversary of his assassination with my family, Bozee and Yaya and Layla, was really empowering. We got the opportunity to hear from Ambassador Andrew Young, who did some great talk around continuing the work around social justice, but he also talked about how Dr. King didn't feel a lot of pain in that moment. And it was amazing to be with someone who was with him in that moment and chose to continue the work after his death. We also had the opportunity to attend Palm Sunday service at Ebenezer Baptist Church, and that was just an awesome experience for us to sit in the same seats that some of the most powerful freedom fighters of our time have sat in. One of the most powerful experiences for us as a family was when we stopped at the Viola Louisa marker, and that's where they learned that Viola Louisa was the first white woman to lose her life during the Civil Rights Movement. She was murdered by the Ku Klux Klan, and my daughters just found that to be really awful. But they also learned that it wasn't just black folks fighting for civil rights, but there were a lot of people involved in the movement. When we stopped at Tuskegee University in Alabama, we had the opportunity to teach our daughters about Booker T. Washington and his position on the condition of black people during that time. They also were really heavily impacted by our visit to the 16th Street Baptist Church, where four little girls lost their life, and those little girls are so close to aid to Yaya and Layla Love that they were highly impacted by the presentation and just by being in the church and learning about the experience. We also went over to Kelly Ingram Park and learned about how Bull Connor gave permission for the dogs to be released on those young teenage protesters and people of all ages. When we went to Jackson and we visited the home of Medgar Evers, that was really powerful, particularly that his blood is still in the driveway of the home. We all, as a family, just found that to be a really powerful statement, and it helps you understand that it wasn't long ago that these things went on in American history. So again, it was a powerful opportunity for us to teach our daughters about American history and the Civil Rights Movement and align it to the things that are still happening today. Overall, it was a powerful experience for us as a family. We were able to see firsthand some of the work of the Civil Rights Movement and the freedom fighters that fought for justice, and we learned a lot about the work that still needs to be done